Hello everyone, Shadefyre here, and today I'm taking a first impressions look at Hollow Knight, a 2D Metroidvania about a determined little bug man, and that's really all I know about it, so we're just going to jump in here blind. I like this very melancholy sort of track that we start with. That's fine. Yeah. Turn the brightness up a little because my monitor is always a little too dark. See, I believe this is actually about quite a few bug people. At least our protagonist and some of the enemies are bug people. The ancient, sealed-away cocoon has undergone metamorphosis, as foretold in the prophecy. And there's our little fella there. Alright, so here we are, we're this little stag beetle type fella. Okay, we got a regular kind of attack, got a jump, but no double jump, and we've got some alien heads, which I guess are probably our health. So we don't have too much of a setup, it looks like our fella's heading towards some sort of town or something. Okay, and this is probably currency. Well, I believe we have reached a Metroidvania point, because I bet this leads somewhere that we either drop down later on, or we'll have an ability to wall jump. But let's see, it looks like the only things we can do right now are jump and attack. Nothing fancy. I do like this art style, though. I guess there's no love between Bugman and just Bug. I was maybe a little worried there that he was spraying acid when I hit him, but it looks like I'm not taking damage. Does fairies do anything? Nope, they just glow. So that's not a door. Can we bring up a map? It's not really a Metroidvania without a map. Hallownest. Okay. Prepare your shell to heal damage. Okay, so we do have a healing move, but I haven't taken damage yet, so it's not relevant yet. Are these gonna collapse? Nope, they're just dusty with age. I am playing this with a controller because I find it usually works better for these kind of side-scrollers. And also the game does recommend it when you boot it up. Oh, higher beings, these words are for you alone. As in, hey, we're talking to the player. Or maybe it's just talking to the bugman. Maybe he is considered a higher being. So yeah, we can heal that damage I took from that spike with our enemy juice. What? What is that? Okay. For a second there, I thought we were dealing with a duck beetle, and that would have been too much. You don't actually have that much invincibility, which is why I took a second hit there. And don't have enough juice for another heal. Gonna guess that those spikes probably will kill me. Currency also does not auto-collect. God damn. Gotta watch out for those spikes. Those stalagmites, because they might fall on your head. Okay, doesn't look like fall damage there. Little bit of a false stun, but no full fall damage. Okay, those... one of those is probably gonna fall on me. Well, taking a lot of hits here, but... it's not too big of a deal, since these guys only do one alien head of damage. You know, it's been a while since I played a game like this. Okay, so I think we got some soul hearts there. And temporary health that'll be lost once we lose it. For good. I feel like the last one of these kind of games I really played was Dust. An Elysian Tale. Back on the 360. Can I climb this? Looks a little climbable, but I guess not. Which is a shame, because there's a resource node there. But, I bet we'll get an ability so we can climb up these. Okay, a lot of spikes. Also, under area. Watch out for these spikes. You can actually see them now that I'm looking at them, which ones will fall. Can I break those? No. Well, shit. So, that looks like we're going to need some kind of dash or hover ability. Oh shit. Okay, good. I was like, I'm just going to push myself into the spikes when I jump down there, as I was falling to the right. The land of King and Creator. Step across this threshold and obey our laws. Bear witness to the last and only civilization, the Eternal Kingdom, Hallownest. So I get the description that some people are saying that this is a bit Dark Souls in its actual just kind of mood and setting, in that we are exploring this once grand but now decayed world. I mean, if this is actually the origin of bug civilization, it's even a bit Lordran there. And we're just a mysterious wanderer who has arrived here to... well, they've got power here, so I guess it can't be that ruined. Dirtmouth, the fading town. Okay, so this is probably a hub, isn't it? Where we can spend our squishy things that we picked up. Stay a while and listen.
Yes, sir.
The caverns below. It used to be there was a great kingdom beneath our town. Maybe a little bit more Dark Souls 2 then, with the kingdom beneath the town. Okay, got our health back, but we lost our temporary hearts.
Akala, M Tono.
So I wonder if we'll find NPCs down below who will then come back here and we can, you know, buy stuff. Yeah, like the mapping person. Which means there probably is a map, we just don't have it yet. Okay, so this... Well, that just dropped me straight down. I thought it was an elevator. Can I climb this? It doesn't look like you can climb back up the chain. Oh, no, there was an ascend option. It just wasn't there until I walked away. I was just gonna say, I want to go to the right to see what's over there, because, you know, you always want to explore your boundaries before you delve into the dungeon. Okay, so we'll need some sort of key or something to get through there. Now we can delve into the dungeon and see exactly what kind of game this is. I mean, I've got a pretty good idea what kind of game this is, but... maybe we'll find a boss or something down here. There's something a little concerning about your hit that kind of makes it feel like something is damaging you, when really it's just kind of an effect. Also, that looks like it's gonna fall on my head. Guess not. Oh, look at this dopey little fella. Oh, well, there he goes. Yeah, there's not really a lot of complexity to combat yet. I basically just press X. He does kind of a left to right swing, but you can see that they're pretty much the same. There's a very sad caterpillar up there. I don't think I can talk to him. There's no, like, inspect. Alright, then. You'll just have to face your sadness on your own. Those guys are also very Metroid, those little bugs that go around the platforms. This is a very large area that we're in. Send through the verdant wilds and fungal groves to the city of this kingdom's heart. All wishes shall be granted, all truth revealed. You look like a boss, or not. I'm wondering if I have to knock this back at him. Nah, it doesn't look like I can hit it. Alright. Not getting through there just yet. That guy seems to be more of a barrier than an enemy. Oh, shit. Landed right on him. What is... this looks like something I should be able to pick up. Oh, guess not. Are these like old cocoons I'm breaking?
Oh, dumb chats da.
Grubbins, sure.
Choco, let's get this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we should be able to buy a compass now. This map is not nearly as useful as you'd want from a Metroidvania map. Which is a shame. Oh, shit. Did not jump a second time. I mean, at this point, I'm just kind of exploring where I can go. Kind of finding the, you know, item requirement limitations of the area. Oh, no, that's a dead end. I didn't mean to go through that door yet. Is this a boss? Is this Goopy fella? Alright. I don't know, it's kind of a combat challenge of some variety. Wasn't too bad. Took more damage than I needed to, but again, still gotta get used to fighting, you know, aerial enemies and stuff. Fills up my bug juice in case I need to heal. And there's also a bench here, which seems like it saves the checkpoint there. So I wonder if I die, will I respawn at this bench now? Kind of like a bonfire. It's not gonna make me do this challenge again, that's nice. Yeah, I have no idea where I am right now. I guess I'm kind of next to that area on the left, where the bug guy's face is. That probably doesn't help you guys very much. What's this? Is that something? It looks like something. A lot of grubbins. I don't know what they're called, but now I'm gonna call them grubbins. Seems like a good name for bug money. It looks like you can also attack up and down, which is good to know. Because you can't always do that. Dead end. And cannot jump that gap. So this is a dead end for us. For practical purposes, for now. What about... I was gonna say, what about over here, but that's where the fountain was. Or was it? No, the fountain was the glowing white door. This is why I need a map. I am so bad at navigating these kind of games. I, like, immediately forget where I'm going at all times. Don't seem to have any kind of dodge or anything yet. Aside from just jump. Have any way to grab the ledge yet. Just gotta go through the sandworm plains. There's one enemy in Dark Souls 2 that these guys remind me of. It's these big worms that pop out of the wall. Except those guys you can actually kill. Hmm. You won't fool me again. I know you guys aren't duck bugs now, so I can handle you. You can see how I might make that mistake when their mandibles were closed, and that sound they make. They certainly aren't ordering us in this early on. We're opening up a lot of paths. I don't really know what this symbol means. Kind of implies that this leads back up to the town, maybe? Another bench. A toll machine with the symbol of a stag. Insert Geo. I prefer Grubbins. So that's interesting. A Metroidvania with a currency gate. It's those bugs from Final Fantasy IX. Stagways. Okay, so this is our kind of warp system. Kind of like the bonfire warping, I guess. And we don't even have to put a little plant in front of him to get his attention. Well, shit. So now this shop should be open.
Bapanada.
Wayward compass. I don't know what notch cost means. Man, we really have to buy stuff that's standard issue for heroes like Samus. So this stuff won't fill out on my map until I actually pay for it. It's interesting. Well, I can't afford the compass yet, so maybe I should buy the quill, but I feel like it'd be better to save up for the compass. After all, filling out extra areas of the map won't help me much if I don't know which one I'm in. Oh, is this also open? Okay, this is where we came from. Thur. Got anything to say about the shop lady?
Misu. Akala, Mtono.
Alright, let's head back in a little bit longer, and then I think we'll call it. Because I think you can tell what kind of game this is. I think melancholy is a pretty good word to describe the general feel of this game. So, is the stagway the thing in the middle of the map? Or is that a boss? These guys really don't drop a lot of currency. Someone else making sad sounds. Big fella. Yep, don't want to mess with him. I can hurt him, but I don't think I can do more damage than he does to me. Definitely not getting through there anytime soon. How much do we need? 220, I think, for the compass. Well, at least I know I haven't been this way yet. This looks like a boss chamber. And that looks like a treasure we get for defeating the boss. Alright, I'm game. There's the big fella. Alright, pretty easy pattern. Just have to go under him when he jumps. Oh, shockwave. Okay. There's a creepy baby ghost inside of him. And now we're in phase two. I'm not really a knight, I'm actually a baby ghost. That's why he's a false knight. Yeah, he landed on my head. I wonder if we can do anything with those orbs that drop, or if those are just something we need to avoid. I mean, I'm still hurting him. Give, baby. So, I mean, it's not too bad, because he drops the healing goop. Are we gonna have to fight him again down there? Baby ghost, leave this place. Oh, what's this? City crest. Sloan slab bearing the crest of the Hallownest capital city. Insert on the back, so some sort of key. Ah! It's alive. Well, bye. So, what's our treasure? Just a bunch of money. It's a little disappointing. I suppose the only reason to fight him was to get the city crest more than anything. Actually, I don't know if we can cross the gap that was created when he fell, but if we can, there was another door up there that was locked. Had some nice weeping echoes here. Yeah, okay, we can't get across. Interesting that the armor stays, but the baby ghost did not. Well, that was a pretty successful first boss. What's up with this place? This seems like a bad place to be a bug.
Gwen on in, Mayor.
And the gift was death. Consumed the vengeful spirit. Tap B to unleash the spirit. So that uses our healing as well, but now we have a projectile attack, it seems.
Gwen on in, Mayor.
Haha, I locked you in with this new magic. Hope it works out for you. Wow, that's quite a bit more impressive than I expected. It also didn't use that much my meter. Well, I think we've made some pretty good progress, so that might be a good time to call it for Hollow Knight. This seems pretty cool. You know, I like the melancholy... I mean, I hate to use Dark Souls in a comparison, but sort of Dark Souls-esque atmosphere. Because I feel like when people compare things to Dark Souls, atmosphere is not usually the thing that comes up. But I mean, obviously this plays very little like Dark Souls. This is very much a kind of melee-focused Metroidvania. You know, melee and magic. That is pretty powerful. I'm digging that as our main ranged attack. Use it in midair. But yeah, this... Oh, I fell on the spikes. Nice that the spikes don't actually kill you, they just take away health and put you back on a ledge. Because a lot of these games, the spikes will be the thing that kills you instantly. I'm trying to think if any of the Metroid games have actual spikes. I don't think so. Usually they have some sort of health-draining liquid instead. I thought that was maybe the beast he wanted us to slay, but just gave us a bunch of soul. This is probably the guy we need to kill. And he shoots out these guys so we can get our energy back. Can't hit him when we're close, though. Shit. Gonna need to heal from that. I wanted to hit him out of the air. And I died. Let's find out what happened. Oh geez, we have a spooky ghost inside of us too. Okay, so I didn't respawn at the... Well, I guess I wouldn't respawn at the bench because it's outside of there. But, yeah, that's Hollow Knight. It's only like $16 on Steam, so it's not super overpriced or anything. And it just seems like a cool little Metroidvania. I've heard the biggest complaint about this game is that it doesn't do anything too unique for Metroidvanias. But, I mean, if it's a good Metroidvania, those don't come around too often, so I'm totally fine with them. It just being a very good, if kind of standard, Metroidvania. Anyhow, I've been Shadefyre, this is Hallownest, and I hope you will join me again for some other weird bug adventures. Until then, you folks all take care.